to the Mass Music Morning Show. This is Shlomo Bowe. Now today we're going to be talking about our favorite music videos. Shamus actually was telling me a little bit about his earlier, but he didn't reveal too much.
I couldn't. You know, I had to save it for the discussion. You know, I wanted to make it a good one. Like I said, I'm not going for popularity. I'm not going for the most, you know, most viewed music videos of all time. I'm going for my personal favorite. All
right.
And if I may, I'm going to start us off with Bob Marley featuring Lauryn Hill, Turn Your Lights Down Low.
I've never seen the video for that.
Fantastic video. They got a little soccer going on. Lauryn singing, Bob singing. They're doing their thing. My favorite. The reason I think it's my favorite is because back in the day growing up, whenever I was getting ready for school with my mom and brother, my mom would always toss it on. She had it like on a VHS, like recorded
what?
It.
Really?
Yeah, because you could like record TV if you like put it onto the VHS. So she would do that for all the music videos.
So your mom would just bootleg these joints.
Exactly. And then she would play it in the morning while we were getting ready. And I love this song so much. Oh, and it brings you back. You know, it's a bit of a nostalgic type of record for me. So I think that's why it's my personal favorite.
That's awesome.
It's a good one. Highly recommended it if you haven't seen it.
Definitely. Turn Your Lights Down Low, Bob Marley.
And Lauryn Hill.
Lauryn Hill. I got one for you.
What's that?
My favorite one, my favorite music video probably of all time, is the Lollipop music video with Lil Wayne.
Oh, Lil Wayne, that's
I was kind of thinking that, man.
Yeah.
It definitely popped into my head when the question was proposed, I will say.
And there's one scene in particular. He's standing on top of the Hummer limo, riding through Vegas, and I was like, this is the greatest. Maybe that's why I want to get a limo.
Yeah.
That's the greatest scene in music video history.
His outfit on that was also amazing.
Oh, the leather jacket, bro, looking fresh as hell.
I love that video. That song, too, I mean, that was a period of time. Definitely.
Oh, yeah. And honestly, when the first scene where he's in the telly, it's just like every time I'm in a hotel looking in the mirror, I'm like, yo, this is how I feel. I feel like the Lollipop music video.
Yeah. No, that's a timeless one right there.
Oh, yeah. And, I got an honorable mention as well.
What's that?
It's got to be Snoop Dogg, Dr. Dre, California Love.
That's another great one.
Not Snoop Dogg, sorry. Dr. Dre and Tupac. When they ride through the desert. Oh, my goodness. It was always cinematic. I remember as a little kid watching it. Mm-hmm. And it's a little scary how it starts off because it's like, it's kind of mysterious. It's very dark. And then they start riding like Humvees into the desert. I'm like, this is some West Coast gangster shit.
Yeah, it was a hard production, man, back in that day.
For real.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What was yours, Chris? What are you thinking of?
I'm thinking Big Pimpin', man. You know what I'm saying? I think that's the original it's the original video that really made me enjoy watching music videos. Like, I remember being really young and this coming on MTV back when they used to do music videos like all day long.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And I would say, man, this video right here really set the tone for, you know, having ladies in your videos, like going wild. It was girls gone wild, basically. I remember watching some kind of documentary or something like that where they were asking all the dudes from Rockefeller like what was going on and yada yada yada. So they explained this video, and they were like, yeah, so you know, we went down in like Trinidad or something like that, and we rented this yacht. And we had all these video vixens on there, and it was literally just a party. They were just throwing some wild party, and the camera was just catching everything that was going on. They moved it from the boat, and they came inland, and ended up just going to festival down there. Really? Festival was taking place at the same time,
and they just
ran through the festival and like hopped on trucks, and you know, were just kind of going wild. And you know, that's kind of how Rockefeller really did their thing, man. Mm-hmm. It was a very natural kind of connection. Of course, Jay-Z, man, as the GOAT rapper from up north, you know, really did his thing on the track, along with a little bit of Southern flavor from Bun B. And rest in peace, Pimp C.
Yeah.
So, you know, the combinations in this, the flavors and the seasoning in this video are impeccable. It's hard to match. So, Big Pimpin', I would say,
super
my
legendary
favorite, man. And, you know,
super legendary. Yeah. There's a lot of lore around, like you said. Like, I've seen interviews too with people just talking about, and a lot of rappers reference like the Big Pimpin', like shorties from that shoot. There's a lot of lore in hip hop about that very record right there.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Jimmy, what you got for us?
What are we feeling, Versace?
This question is absolutely impossible because I can see on Chris's screen, I'm watching the Big Pimpin' video with him. And it's like, I love videos which goals are to make it look like the greatest day ever.
Yeah.
Like, they capture what looks like this person's greatest day. Like, it's I can almost say Big Pimpin', but I have two. It's a tie for me, and it's for two totally different reasons. Number one is Stand by Eminem.
Oh, hell yeah.
Because, like,
that's crazy.
I remember the first time I watched that video, I was a little kid, and I just was, like, so shell-shocked from the ending of that video. And yeah. It's like him, like, I was so captured to the story. He told a great story, and that song is also excellent.
Mm-hmm.
And then the tie is with Beautiful Liar by Beyonce and Shakira. Beyonce and Shakira are the most beautiful women I can think of, and it's just exactly what you would want from prime Beyonce and Shakira, and a great song too. So yeah, those are my two favorite videos.
Yo, amazing. I'm gonna have to piggyback on that, James. Eminem, there's a video of his called The Way I Am. First scene, he just walks to the edge and jumps off a building, and the whole video is him just flying down the side of a building rapping. And this is like the first time I ever like understood what a green screen was. But even before that, I'm like, at the end of this video, he's going to splat on the ground. So I remember the first time I watched it as a little kid, I couldn't move because I'm like, what is going to happen at the end of this song? Terrifying.
Yeah, definitely. That's one word I'd use to describe Eminem's music for sure. It's terrifying, horrifying, and all of the above. But on a much better note, because Versace had me thinking about it, how these music videos like to portray an amazing day. And I think Today Was a Good Day by Ice Cube.
Oh,
that's a classic music video right there. Just
very cinematic.
I love how that video was made. I mean, the song obviously is a hit, but the way they made that video definitely added an extra layer of lovability to the track. But my honorable mention that I had originally come up with was Window Shopper by 50 Cent. One of my favorite videos ever. He's whipping a Maserati in it, and this is in what year? Like, long time ago, you know what I mean? So, 50 Cent, Window Shopper, an amazing song, a timeless record, but that video, chef's kiss.
50 Cent has a plethora of great... I remember he does. In the club where he's upside down, yes, doing the
sit-ups. Eminem watching him.
And then he's like running on the treadmill. It was like the first time we were really introduced to 50 Cent on like a mainstream level. Mm-hmm. And it's like, who the hell is this dude?
Yeah. And it's crazy because it was almost as if like, you know, I feel like how they portrayed it, how he's like in a lab and mm-hmm. like, you know, Dr. Dre and Eminem are watching him and studying
taking
him.
Taking notes and
like,
shit.
It did a very good job of accurately portraying how he really came up in hip-hop music. You know what I mean? And like you say, I can't think of anyone else who's had a debut like
quite
that
like
on that level.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I was like, who the hell is this guy? You know what
Shout
I mean?
Shout out to 50 Cent, man.
Yeah, no, he has a plethora of good ones for sure.
And, you know, like James said, it's such a hard question. Anybody out there that, you know, you have a favorite music video, hit us up on IG, slide into our DMs, Twitter, Facebook. Let us know. What do you think? James has one more thing to say.
What
though.
Song for Rick Ross video was it? Him and DJ Khaled get pulled over.
Oh,
and
man.
He runs out of options and he jumps off the bridge. I've seen that recently.
Somebody said that in the group chat.
I had one of my biggest laughs ever. Runners.
Mass Music Radio.